Well, I just aged myself probably about 2 years. Biebs went to go play golf this morning. It's Sunday. And he never, ever, ever, obviously I was still sleeping because hi, gotta get our beauty rest. And he never, ever resets the alarm after he leaves in the morning. He just leaves and I'm still sleeping, but he doesn't reset the alarm. And then when I get up in the morning, I feed the birds and I change their water outside. So back door here, front door way over there, and that's where the alarm is. So I got the big ass bowl of water in my hand, orange is sitting here, fish is sitting here. I open the door and the alarm goes off. I almost threw the bowl of water out the door, but I didn't. I set it on the floor. I threw the Birkins off my feet, trying not to fall over one of the two cats that was by my feet, trying to haul ass for their lives as well, and turn off the alarm. Because if you don't turn it off in like 20 seconds, the freaking cops will show up at your house. Like, the cops have showed up here before, the fire department has shown up here before, because one time we were changing out the batteries in our smoke detectors, and I don't know, something happened, and the whole alarm system went off, and like right past, like right over our back wall, the fire department is literally like right there, and they were here in like 1 second. We heard the fire alarm, like we heard the fire trucks coming, and we're like, no, 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 they're not coming here. Bitch, they were on their way here. So, now that my heart's probably still like 90, because every time that alarm, every single time that alarm goes off, it scares me, and I'm like, I don't even know where that's coming from, and then it clicks, like, oh, it's coming from my house. So we're gonna film today after I drink coffee, obviously, because I want to make a video, like a YouTube video, showing you guys how to make tie-dyed socks, because a lot of you guys wanted to see, which I didn't know. I made like a quick little TikTok video about them. Like, I haven't made tie-dye anything in years, and I feel like I've just seen tie-dye everywhere. I saw some people making just straight up like one colored socks on TikTok, and I was like, bitch, I'm gonna make me some tie-dye Nike socks, because I have so many of these like white crew socks. So these are all the pairs that I made, and I love how all of them turned out. Like, I was like iffy at first. I was like, oh no, I feel like I'm messing them up, but I honestly don't think you can mess up tie-dye socks. We actually have a pretty busy week because we are going to Fort Lauderdale. Lottie dottie, we fun party. We are meeting Carly down there. I was actually supposed to go to New York tomorrow, like a really quick trip. I think we flew in on the 9th and flew out on the 10th, but the trip got canceled due to the coronavirus. Right. Shrimpy. Your butt is being perfectly cut off from the camera. I'm gonna enjoy this coffee and then we'll start getting ready. I'll take you to the back.
1 hour later.
What is that right there? What's that? Is that that?
Yeah, that's that.
Okay. Hello, you beautiful humans. Today, I'm gonna show you guys how we're gonna take these plain white socks, boring, and we're gonna turn them into these fun tie-dye colorful socks. I got so many requests on how to do these tie-dye socks. I was like, whoa. I love how they turned out. So I was like, you know what? I got lots of white socks that I can dye. So I figured that I would do a YouTube video to show you guys how to do it. It's super duper easy, and it just turns your socks into like these fun things. Like, you would buy these, right? Like, you would buy these if you saw these in the store. Like, if I was walking around and I saw these, bitch, I'm snatching these up so quick. I think that these two are my favorite, the pink and like the lime green version. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, they're all my favorite. I was really, really excited when I was washing them. So hopefully you guys will be just as excited as I was. So I'm gonna show you what I did. Really, there's no special way to tie-dye. I think the most important thing when you are tie-dyeing something is how you are like mashing it up and rubber banding it together. So I'm gonna show you what I think worked best for me. The sky is pretty saturated, which I don't mind. I actually really love it. I feel like it looks like the sky, but it is a lot more blue than tie-dye. I'm gonna show you how I got these. So let's quickly run through what
supplies you guys will need to do this. First things first, you're gonna need white socks. They don't have to be Nike socks, they just have to be white. Next, you're gonna need some sort of tie-dyeing kit. You don't technically have to get a tie-dyeing kit, you can definitely just use regular dye. This is just gonna make it a little bit easier on you, plus everything that you need is inside this kit. So this guy comes with your dye, rubber bands, gloves, and a protective surface to work on. Again, you don't have to have a tie-dye kit, it's just gonna make things easier and quicker for you. I already have my protective surface left over from my last one, so I'm just going to spread that out. Even though the table that I'm working on, it doesn't matter if it gets stained or not. But if you are concerned with whatever area you're working on that it's gonna get, you know, messed up, make sure you lay down your plastic film or whatever this is. I don't even know what this is, honestly. It's just gonna make everything safe. So all of your dyes come like this with a little bit of dye powder on the bottom, and then you just add water to whatever color you're going to use. Make sure that you're using the color, because the color is only good for 72 hours after you add the water to it. So don't like fill them all up with water, just pick the colors that you wanna use and fill those up with water so that you can use the other guys for another project. And last but not least, you're gonna need a bowl of water. There is water in here, you can't see it. Oh, there you go, you can see it a little bit. But I'm just gonna use the bowl of water to saturate my socks because I'm going to be dyeing them when they're a little damp. You're also gonna need some kind of Ziploc bag or baggie, whatever you wanna do, because you're going to be placing your socks in the bag to let them sit overnight. And you wanna put them in the bag to keep them damp so that the color really saturates into the sock. You definitely don't have to wet your sock. I just like to tie-dye things on wet because I think that it spreads and it looks a little more blended and it's not so harsh. So, let me go get some plastic bags. So I'm just gonna take my socks and put them in the water just to get them saturated. ASMR. And then you wanna squeeze them out really good. Fill the water up to this line here. So let's go fill these. Okay, now that we're all up close and personal, I'm gonna show you what I do. So I dye each sock individually. I don't dye them together, but I'm sure if you wanted to dye them together, you could just tie them up together. I like each one to have its own individual little vibe. So I'm gonna take our rubber bands, get these undone so it's just easier for you. And then what I did is I like bunch this front part up, you know, and then I'm like twisting it at the same time, which is kind of a tie-dye technique, like the twist, but you just kind of want to get all kinds of little rolls and crevices in your sock, because wherever it's like scrunched up, that's where the dye is not gonna be. So you can like take this part here and kind of scrunch it around. You can just do like a random little pattern, but like I said, the more kind of scrunched up it is, the better your tie-dye is gonna look. And then you want to be firm here, so I'm holding this very tightly, and then you're going to take one rubber band and you're going to tie it this way. Just two times is good, so then you have something that looks like this, and then you're going to tie your other rubber band the opposite way, so like this. So you kind of have four little sections, you know, like it's kind of sticking up like that, so I'm going to make sure that he is locked down like that. So he's not perfect. Also, I have dye on my fingers and it's already dyeing my sock a little bit. So make sure you use your gloves because the dye will stain your fingers. So here's what he looks like. Put him to the side. Now you have two little sockies ready to be tie-dyed. You're gonna definitely wanna put some gloves on for this because your fingers will get stained. If you don't care, then don't wear gloves. But if you don't wanna get stained, wear gloves. So we're gonna go with this purple shade. This is what it looks like after you mix it up with water. Just make sure you shake it up real good and there's no powder left on the bottom. I like to stay like in the little quadrants, the little four corners. You wanna make sure it's fully saturated, and then you're going to flip it over and make sure you get the other side as well. So you're just gonna squirt it on there. I like to leave a little bit of white so that I know there's gonna be white on the sock. But I make sure I go over the areas that I am putting the color quite a bit, like that. And then you're just gonna wanna keep flipping him so that you're saturating everything. You shoot it down in the middle. Again, just shoot some color in there. Flip it over. Place these inside the Ziploc bag. So then after these guys are in the bag, I'm just gonna sit them to the side. They are done until tomorrow when we wash them out. Could definitely, you know, just do some shit like that if you wanted to. Oh, we don't need the cat hair, thank you. You know, you don't have to cover the whole sock. You could be like that and done, leave it like that. I like a lot of the white in the sock. Or color the whole thing. Use the whole bottle if you want. You know, it's your sock. Okay, I'm gonna leave those like that. So there's a lot of white in that one. And then we will let these guys sit overnight as well. So after your socks have been sitting for at least 6 to 8 hours, I left mine overnight. It wasn't a full 24 hours, but I definitely went to sleep and washed them out the morning after. You're gonna want to rinse them in cold water before you chop off the rubber bands. So just rinse it until the water runs clear. Then you can get rid of the rubber bands. I saved my rubber bands just in case I wanna use them again. Some of them will be stained, but that is okay. And then you're gonna want to wash your socks separately in the washer and then dry them. So I put them on the lowest amount of time. I was going to wash them together, but once I had rinsed all my socks and I picked them up and they're still damp and I held them together, some of the color did transfer to the sock because it is just like a white sock. I feel like if you do more than one color tie-dye, you could probably get away with washing your socks together. But once I saw that the color transferred on to the sock, and there are some like blue stains on the sock and it barely touched it. So I didn't want to risk putting them in the washer machine and then the white parts of my sock being a different color. So I did wash each one of them individually, but like I said, if you're doing tie-dye that has more than one color and maybe like less white than my socks have, I feel like you could get away with it. And after they are all washed and clean and dried, you are left with your very own tie-dye socks. So cute for spring and summer. I would seriously have purchased all of these socks, but no, why purchase them when you could just make them at home? I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do make some tie-dye socks, please tag me in them. I would love to see your creations. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. That is it for me. I don't have anything else to tell you guys except I love you and I will see you super duper soon in another video. Bye guys. When I throw it back, is it fast enough? If I speed it up, can you handle that? You ain't ready for this work. Now watch me, throw it, throw it.